Here in the old part of Shanghai, it's easy to get a sense of the scale of the crisis now facing China, as well as the reason why the government is so spooked. Here, amid the single-room homes of this city's poorest residents, people have been buying shares by the shedload. Those who've lost most, of course, are those who climbed onto the share-buying bandwagon late, just before the crash. Lin Jinsha is a mother and an owner of a small shop. She ploughed a large part of her savings into the stock market in May. She's since lost $16,000. Chinese investors have more than 100 million accounts here on the Shanghai Stock Exchange, and that is, in part at least, because the government has been actively encouraging the share-buying frenzy. Premier Li Keqiang himself has been cheerleading the power of the markets to pump money into big business while at the same time making the small investor feel richer. If the attempt to stop the share price slide can be seen as dangerous political meddling, then so too can the attempt to pump up the markets in the first place. It's an illustration of how in China the shadow of the Communist Party hangs over the whole economy. So the government faces the possibility of widespread public anger, but there is perhaps a greater risk, that of further damage to an already struggling economy. Chun Jihui is a tailor who also came to the market late, and for the past few weeks while sewing his clothes, he's been busy checking his share prices on his computer. He's seen his savings and spending power wiped out, losing almost $2,000. The harder China now tries to mend investors' confidence, the danger is the more they'll panic. John Sudworth, BBC News, Shanghai.